But I think so. I hope that they learn something, because we need to say, you know, we are Kenyan. And that's because, I mean, if they look at anyway, Europe or America, you know, so America, so it's a multinational people, you know, you see, there's yellow people, black people, red, Indians, whatever, and all these people, so they really defend the country, so they say United States of America. So that's the name we have to use in Kenya, to say this Kenya. And then if we go back, anyway, so we know, you know, where you come from. So that's, it doesn't matter, but then we have to have this image, which we have to feel, to create. So this is what I'm talking about, the image we have to sell, the product we have to sell is Kenya. We are not selling Kalenjin, we are not selling Kikuyu, we are not selling Luo. But in that case, I think maybe people, they will understand better what we need is security in the country, development in the country, hospitals in the country, education in the country. So all those things, so that's what we need. We don't need to fight, because this is not going to take us anywhere. We fight, we destroy everything, we start again from zero. So we are going back for maybe another 40 years. So coming back from those 40 years to reach where we are, so people, they will be 200 years in front of us. So we will never catch up. So we play catch up all the time.
If you had stayed in Kenya, do you think you would have been as successful as you have been in Denmark?
Well, in that case, I don't think so, because, I mean, you know, talking about the country, so this, I mean, you know, sometimes the culture and the community is more stronger than, so there's things also you have to fit in, because, you know, if you try to isolate yourself in the community, it's like, so people, they can see you are different persons, so, but the thing, you have to be in the community, you have to oblige, to give something to the nation or maybe the village. And that's, so many people, they are losing that, because, I mean, diverting the concentration. So sometimes, even if you say it's too easy, it's just talking, it's just do this, just be here. It takes a lot of energy. And that's also, if I was in Kenya, so maybe I would not be sitting here today. Or maybe I would not be a world record holder for 8 years. Because if I was in Kenya, so winning one Olympic, so that could be maybe the end of it, you know, and then I was the hero of the nation. And that's, so this is what I was telling about the knowing to handle the success and also the defeat, is to make that balance. Because, you know, sometimes you get success, things can be too easy, everybody can say, oh, you are the champion, you are the hero. And you think you are that, really, but then, sure, you are the hero. But then you cannot show it, because it's just recent people clapping you on the shoulders, you know. You are the champion, you are this. And all of a sudden, you are not the champion anymore. So we go to clap on the other person, you are the champion, just like this. Things change.
Last question. Is it easy for an athlete to be forgotten by everybody of their successful career?
It's very easy, but then, you know, it depends. If you really get into it, build a name, build the image, and then also make the history. So the history is not easy to forget, but the results is easy to forget, because results everybody can make, you know. Like now I was saying about Usain Bolt, so maybe winning all those three medals, breaking three records, if you cannot show that again next year in Berlin, so it's easy for him to say, okay, he's forgotten. Because now Michael Johnson, so maybe he ran very well, but maybe he didn't make that history. So for him now, it's like Michael Johnson is forgotten. Kalu is still having the name, because he made history in that time. He was doing long jump, running 100, 200, and all this, and he made a name, and he was good personal. He knew the way he was selling it, so he sold very well. So if you look at all these people coming from Tim Montgomery, Maurice Green, Justin Carlin. So all these people, they deliver the results, but they are forgotten. They didn't make history. They were not in two Olympics. They were in one Olympic. But Carl Lewis was in almost three Olympics in 84, 88, 96, and also plus the World Championship. So, you know, staying for that period is people getting to know that name. So that name was stayed for a long period. Michael Johnson stayed for a long period, but was in 200, in 91, maybe in World Championship in Tokyo. And then he got a little bit lost in Barcelona, so I didn't see him a lot. I think he was not there. So you see, winning and getting away and coming again. So if you maintain a little bit, so that name will stay there forever. Because in women, I can say Mali Note. She's the woman, she made the name.
Yeah.
Even people still remember Mali Note, even if she was not a world champion or an Olympic champion. So in that period, so that's what is to make the history. So the history can stay there forever. But then, you know, the results, one-time results, can be forgotten very easily. Because nowadays we are looking at the results. We are not looking about how many years have you been running. We are looking about the record now. You are the champion today, but you are not the champion tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. So I hope it's going to be a good story.